we need to talk about Waves Studioverse and what it is. The original plan by Waves was to have a grand release for Waves Studioverse and also introduce subscriptions only at the same time. We all know how that ended up in huge backlash for the subscription plans. I dedicated 2 videos on it and a whole slew of creators jumped on it like a bunch of vultures. Now, because of this, the whole grand Studioverse release was completely FUBAR. But I think we still need to talk about Waves Studioverse because it offers something I really haven't seen done elsewhere in this way. Waves Studioverse is built around the free Waves Studiorack. This is a free plugin chainer where you can create very complicated plugin chains and very simple ones as well. It also works since the latest version as a plugin wrapper. This, for instance, means that you can run VST3 in Pro Tools. Now, the latest Studiorack incorporates Studioverse. This is basically a large collection of plugin chains with customized settings by creators and well-known audio engineers. These chains all load in Studiorack. Of course, Studioverse will use Waves plugins for the most part, because it's created by Waves and it's a way to monetize for them. But plugin change by other developers are very much possible as well, and my guess is these will pop up in the future. Maybe I will create some of my own. I personally don't use presets that much, but I do appreciate presets from time to time to find inspiration. There are a few ways to get these preset chains. The first is outside of the plugin by visiting the Studioverse part on the Waves website. You go to a creator, look at their chains, pick the one you think you like, copy the link in Studiorack, and it will load all plugins and settings. The second way is to use the search function in Studiorack. You get some tags to further specify your search and some plugins. Just click on one of the results and it will load all plugins. The third way is a lot more interesting in my opinion, and that is to let Studioverse listen to the audio on a track or bus where it will suggest these plugin changes based on the audio track. This is similar to what, for instance, Izotope's Neutron does, but you get basically unlimited combinations of plugins in Studioverse. Let's do it again with this female vocal. Studioverse recognizes this as female vocals and presents a couple of options. I'll go with this one.
A cherry slurpee shared for two. If this is paradise, don't wake me up.
And this is what is used in the plugin chain.
Early mornings and late night snacks, blankets hogging and pillow attacks. Life seems perfect, but is this for real? Or is this all just something I built in my head? Can we all just live in this heaven instead? I think I'm losing it.
With this being a preset, you do need to go in most of the time and fine-tune some of the settings. If you miss some of the plugins used in the chain, you can see which ones are used on the Studioverse page easily, where you can buy them, obviously. Right there is the monetization for Waves. Here are some more changes while I talk about the sponsor for this video, which is not Waves, but DistroKid. Are you a musician looking to get your music onto popular streaming platforms like Spotify and Apple Music? Look no further than DistroKid. With its easy-to-use platform and affordable pricing, DistroKid makes it simple for artists to get their music out there. Plus, you'll keep 100% of the royalties you earn from your streams. Why not give it a try and see for yourself why so many artists are choosing DistroKid to distribute their music? Get 7% off of your first year by using the link in the description. Description of this video. The detection of Studiorack is for the most part pretty spot on, except for a misfire once in a while when the original audio is a little unclear to define. Now, if you don't like what you have chosen, you have to do the selecting of the chain all over again. This is not really fast, and selecting a chain is somewhat like working blind, even though you get tags and audio instrument selections. On the next song, I have used the AI detection and selection for every audio track, and I will A/B between the without plugins and the Studioverse versions.
Shared for two, if this is paradise, don't wake me up. Early mornings and late night snacks, blankets talking and pillow attacks, life seems perfect. Is this for real?
You can hear the Studioverse has its merits, and I can see its usefulness when you are stuck for an idea, or when you want to learn how big names have their plugin chains set up, or when you are very inexperienced and need, let's say, guidance on which plugins to use on whatever you're working on. I don't know if the Studioverse will catch on quickly because of the things which happened in the last few weeks, but at least you'll understand what Studioverse is and how it works. Looking forward to reading your thoughts about this in the comments below. Now, if you want to learn how Studiorack works, watch my video on it. It's displayed on screen and linked in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe.